हेलो एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ मिसेस चेतना पटेल फ्रॉम एलपी सवानी विद्या भवन. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर. हियर यू कैन सी द टाइटल, टू स्टोरीज अबाउट फ्लाइंग. नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर यूनिट हैज़ टू पार्ट्स. हियर यू कैन सी द टाइटल ऑफ बोथ द पार्ट. द फर्स्ट वन हिज फर्स्ट फ्लाइट, विच इज़ एक्चुअली द टाइटल ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक also, and the second one is a black aeroplane. This time we are going to deal only with the first part of it, its first flight. Okay, now before I start with the chapter, I would like to give you a brief introduction about this lesson. The story is about a young seagull who is afraid to fly. Okay, now before I do that, students, I would like to ask you that what was your experience when you first learned how to drive a vehicle? How was your experience? Yes, you have dual experience. First, you are afraid. Secondly, yes, of course, you have an excitement, an adventure that you are going to learn something new. Initially, you face difficulties, but once you learn, there is no bound of excitement and enthusiasm, right? Yes. But the first step, if you don't start, then you will not be able to reach your destination. So the very important is the first step. Right? Okay. So in this particular chapter also, we will see that the seagull is afraid. He lacks confidence, and the family members are there to boost him up and take his first flight. Okay. So this is all about the chapter there. A young seagull is afraid to fly, and how does he conquer his fear? That is what the chapter is about. Okay, so we will start with the chapter, the first flight. The young seagull was alone on the ledge. Ledge means a narrow horizontal shelf projecting from a wall or a cliff. Cliff means hilly area. When on the next page, you have that picture of it, you will come to know very soon. His two brothers and his sisters had already flown away the day before. Okay, so the younger brother and sister of seagull had already learned how to fly. He had been afraid to fly with them. Somehow, when he had taken a little run forward to the brink of the ledge, brink means the edge, and attempted to flap his wing, he became afraid. So this particular line shows that the seagull lacked confidence and he did not believe in himself. The great expanse of sea, that is a vast area, expanse means vast area, stretched down beneath. And it was such a long way down and miles down. Okay. Now, when the seagull saw from the cliff, he could see a vast sea. And it was miles and miles to go. And that made him afraid. He felt certain that his wings would never support him. So he bent his head and ran away back to the little hole under the ledge where he slept at night. Now you can see that every time when the seagull made an attempt, he was afraid, and that is why he would reach at the edge of the brink and return back where it stayed there for the whole night. Even when each of his brother and his little sister, whose wings were far shorter than his own, ran to the brink flapped their wings and flew away. He failed to muster up courage. To muster up means to gather up the courage, which his younger brother and sister could do it very well. To muster up courage, to take that plunge. Plunge means actually to start. You're to start or to jump, which appeared to him so desperate. Okay, we'll continue with the last line. His father and mother had come around calling to him shrilly. Shrilly means very harshly. Upbraiding him, threatening. Upbraiding, scolding. Scolding for what? For not being trying, because his younger brother and sister had already learned how to fly, but here the seagull was not ready to make an attempt, and that is why the parents were very angry. Now see, the scolding of the parents is actually the love of the parents, because the parents want his child to learn, and that is why that scolding was there. To let him starve on this ledge unless he flew away, but for the life of him, he could not move. Yes. Now, the parents of the seagull not only scolded him, but they made him starve also. They did not provide him food. And the seagull, on the other hand, was stubborn. He could go without food, but he did not make an attempt for his life there. Now, as described before, you can see in the picture there, seagull on the ledge, family members, and you can see the cliff. This part is called as a cliff, and this is the edge there. Okay, I hope it's clear now. Fine. Okay, moving on to the next. That was 24 hours ago. Since then, nobody had come near him. Okay, now parents by any means wanted the seagull to learn how to fly, and that is why almost a day have passed without food and water. The parents and his younger brother and sister were on the opposite side of the cliff watching him. The day before, all day long, he had watched his parents flying about with his brother and sister, perfecting them in the art of flight, teaching them how to skim. Skim means to move lightly just above the surface. You must have seen on many Discovery Channel where a bird flies and it comes on the surface of the water, catch hold of the fish and flies away. Okay, so that is called as skimming. Okay, the waves and how to dive for a fish. Okay, so these are all the skills of flying there, which the parents were teaching his younger brother and sister, and all these things were being watched by the young seagull. He had in fact seen his older brother catch his fish, herring, and devour it. Herring is a soft, finned sea fish, and devour means to consume. Okay, I hope it's clear till here. Okay, we'll continue with here. Standing on a rock while his parents circle around, raising a proud cackle. Cackle here means a sound, okay, or calling their young ones or the siblings there. Okay, cackling, that's a sound being made by them. And all the morning, the whole family had walked about on a big plateau midway down the opposite cliff, taunting him with his cowardice. Cowardice means opposite of, you know, strong or brave. Okay, so as I told you before, the whole family were on the opposite of the cliff, and in between them, the parents were teaching the younger brother and sister about all the skills of flying and all. Okay, not only that, but why they stayed on the opposite cliff, they were taunting Seagull for not being brave and all. And why they were doing that? At least these words would made him fly and take his first flight. But no, the Seagull did not make an attempt. See students, if you really need to learn swimming, merely standing on the edge of the swimming pool is not going to help you out. You need to dive into the water. So that first step, which is very important, of course, under the proper guidelines. Okay, now moving further. The sun was now ascending the sky, blazing on his ledge that faced the south. He felt the heat because he had not eaten since the previous nightfall. Okay, now almost 24 hours have passed. In fact, more than that, Seagull was on the cliff without food and water. And of course, now it was becoming very difficult for him. So what happens there? He stepped slowly out to the brink of the ledge and standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wing, he closed one eye and then the other. Now when the Seagull does this activity, parents were watching and they were really very excited, rather feeling happy that the Seagull is going to make an attempt to take his first flight. And so they waited there on the opposite side of the cliff, watching the activity of the Seagull and pretended to be falling asleep. Now here what the parents expected, that the Seagull was actually trying to make the first attempt to fly, but no, the Seagull does all those activity in order to catch the attention of his parents as well as his brother and sister who were on the opposite side of the cliff. Still they took no notice of him. He saw his two brothers and his sister lying on the plateau, dozing with their heads and sunk into their necks. His father was preening. Preening here means actually cleaning activity of the feathers. Students, you must have watched many birds, you know, with the help of their beak, they try to clean their feather there. Okay, so the father was preening, actually cleaning the feathers on his white back. Only his mother was looking at him. She was standing on a little high hump. Hump means a mold or a higher mound there. Her white breast thrust forward. Now and again, she tore at a piece of fish that lay at her feet and then scrape each side of her beak on the rock. Okay, so the mother was actually scraping, taking out small pieces of fish, and every time when she scraped the piece of a fish, she cleaned her beak on the rock by rubbing against it. Now when the Seagull saw the food, what the Seagull took into consideration, that the mother was actually trying to make that food for her, but no. And that is why the sight of the food maddened him. Okay, so the Seagull was going mad because almost for more than 24 hours Seagull had been without food, and that is why the sight of that fish really made him mad. He was literally starving. How we love to tear food that way. Okay, so the activity of tearing, which was actually been done by the mother, he remembered how he used to do that, scraping his beak now and again to wet it. Wet means to sharpen it. Okay, you must have seen how the birds every time, you know, they rub their beak against the rock or things lying beside them. Actually, why they do this activity? They are trying to sharpen their beak so that they can tear any food easily there. Okay, so is it clear? So here we finish with half of the chapter there. The later half we will continue in the next session. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.